Welcome to the Amphenol Broadband Solutions training on the Times Fiber Communications TX15 Flex Feeder Coaxial Cable. In this video, we'll explain the flex feeder features and benefits, look at the connector options, show the tools needed to prep the cable and install the connectors, show the proper cable preparation, and connector installation. Flex feeder has a signal loss of a half-inch hardline cable, but has a mechanical flexibility of a drop cable. It's perfect for MDUs in situations where you need flexibility and tight bending radiuses. It's also great for emergency restorations as well. It's available in standard 60% braid, Tri-Shield 77% braid, and QuadShield 60-40% braid versions. It's offered in indoor, aerial messenger, and direct burial types cable. The aerial messenger is available with rodent repel for protection against squirrel chews, and the indoor cable is available with lifetime, which protects against moisture migration and corrosion. The flex cable uses a three-piece connector similar to hardline connectors, but the cable's not cored, it's prepped like a drop cable. There's a back nut, middle nut, and main body. There are several types of connectors available. First is the pin connector, which is used when connecting to hardline devices such as taps, couplers, and amplifiers. Next is the splice, which is used to connect two pieces of flex feeder cables together. This has two middle nuts and two back nuts and one main body. There's an F female connector, which is used to connect to a drop type cable. And last is the F male, which can be connected to an F port, such as a tap port. The cable preparation and installation is the same for all the connector types. External F type adapters can be used with the three-piece pin connector. To add the adapter, the center pin needs to be trimmed down to 3/8 of an inch. Hand tighten the adapter to the main body and tighten with a wrench. Make sure to keep the main body steady and tighten the adapter to it. The adapters come in F female and F male. Let's take a look at the tools needed for cable preparation and connector installation. First, you'll need a cable prep tool. Here I'm showing two different versions of the tools. This will ensure that the cable is properly prepped for the connector. You'll need a coaxial cable cutter to get a straight cut on the end of the cable. A needle nose or similar pliers comes in handy to remove the cut pieces from the cable. A side cutter is used on the center conductor to get a pyramid cut. A stiff braid brush is used to fold back the braid. A splicer's knife is handy when removing the outer foil. Two 10-inch adjustable wrenches are needed to tighten the connectors. And rubber gloves come in handy to give a firm grip when putting connectors on or folding back the braid. Let's start the cable prepping process. Make sure that the cable that you're using is straight. Use your coaxial cable cutters to cut the end of the cable squarely. Roll the end of the cable in your fingers to round it off before applying the prep tool. This is done so that the blades of the prep tool cut evenly around the diameter of the cable. Place the prep tool on the cable with the direction of the arrow pointing to the end of the cable. The large cutting blade should be placed greater than 1 inch from the end of the cable. You can use the cutting guide on the connector body for the 1 inch measurement. Cut it slightly longer than 1 inch, as we'll trim the center conductor later to form a pyramid cut. Lightly press the prep tool onto the cable to set the blades, and then spin clockwise for 4 or 5 turns until it stops cutting. open the tool, and remove it from the cable. The tool isn't meant to be used to remove the cut pieces. Using a pliers, pinch the end section of the cable to be removed and twist and pull it off. To expose the required quarter inch of braid, use a needle nose pliers or a small tool to remove the jacket at the second cut made by the prep tool. At this stage, the center conductor will be greater than 1 inch long, and the foil and braid will be exposed by a quarter of an inch. Caution should be made to ensure that you haven't removed excess braid with the prep tool. This has an impact on the retention force of the connector. Also be cautious of leaving long braids, which can touch the center conductor and short out the connector. Inspect the center conductor for scoring and scratches. If any are found, start the process over again and do it properly. A scored or scratched center conductor can cause signal impairments. Before folding back the braid and removing the foil, place the connector's back nut onto the cable. Use a stiff brush to fold back the braid evenly around the cable. Don't use your fingers as the salts and oils on your hands could corrode the braid over time. The braid can also be folded back using a gloved hand. If using Tri-Shield cable, remove the outer foil before folding back the braid. A sharp knife or side cutters can be used to help remove the foil. Quad cable has one additional layer of braid. Fold the outer layer of braid evenly back over the jacket using a stiff brush or gloved hand. Remove the outer foil the same way as we did with the Tri-Shield cable. Fold the inner layer of braid evenly back over the jacket using a stiff brush or gloved hand. Use the cutting guide on the connector to measure the correct length of the center conductor. Use the side cutters to create a pyramid trim cut on the center conductor by cutting halfway through the center conductor and then rotating the cutters 90 degrees to complete the cut. Slide the middle nut over the prepared cable end and push the middle nut onto the prepared cable end until the dielectric bottoms out on the recessed internal shoulder. The dielectric will be approximately a half inch below the top of the middle nut. This is visible from the front side of the middle nut. If using a pin-type connector into a hardline device, trim the pin to the correct length using the cutting guide on the device. Insert the pin into the seizure mechanism of the device you're splicing to and tighten the main body to the equipment. Don't tighten the seizure screw at this time. Wait until the cable has been inserted properly into the connector. Guide the middle nut and center conductor into the main body. Using slight forward pressure, hold the main body steady and hand tighten the middle nut to the main body. Don't twist the main body, as that'll scratch the center conductor and could cause signal impairments. Using two 10-inch adjustable wrenches, hold the main body and tighten the middle nut to a dead stop. Holding the middle nut, hand tighten the back nut to the middle nut. Using two 10-inch adjustable wrenches, hold the middle nut and tighten the back nut to a dead stop. The connector installation is now complete. If the pin-type connector was used into a device, tighten the seizure screw now. Let's review what we've covered in this training session on the TX15 flex feeder cable. We explained the flex feeder features and benefits, such as the low signal loss and tight bending radiuses. We showed the different types of connectors, looked at the tools needed for cable preparation and connector installation, showed the proper cable preparation steps, and connector installation. Thank you for viewing this product training on the TX15 Flex Feeder Cable. For additional training topics, see our website at www.amphenolbroadband.com.